The last section of this chapter is titled Titrations, and we're going to encounter titrations very frequently in the laboratory. So a laboratory technique used to determine the concentration of a particular solute is called a titration. So there are three main components that go into a titration. The first is something called a standard solution. And a standard solution is a reagent of known concentration. The second main component of a titration is a solution of unknown concentration. And the objective of the titration is to determine that unknown solution's concentration. The last main component that goes into a titration is something called an indicator. And an indicator is a dye that changes color when the equivalence point is reached. And this brings in another vocabulary word that we're going to have to know, and that is something called the equivalence point. And an equivalence point is defined as the point at which the moles of solute equal the moles of solvent. One of the most common titrations is an acid-base titration. And in an acid-base titration, at the equivalence point, the moles of acid are going to equal the moles of base. So this is going to allow us to perform some of the calculations that involve these titrations. So, for example, we can solve the following problem. What is the molarity of an NaOH solution if 48.0 milliliters is needed to neutralize 35.0 milliliters of 0.144 molar H2SO4. So we can use our solution stoichiometry to determine this particular calculation, and we're going to need to write out our balanced chemical equation. We have H2SO4, and we're going to add that to sodium hydroxide, or NaOH. This is going to give us the products of Na2SO4 plus water. In this particular case, we need to balance out all our components. We have two sodiums on the right, so we need two over here on the left. And by doing so, we're going to need to put a 2 in front of the water to balance out all these components. So the first thing that we're going to have to do is we're going to have to calculate the moles of H2SO4 that's required to reach the endpoint of this titration. So if we have 0.144 moles of H2SO4 per liter, which is our concentration, times the volume, which is 0.0350 liters, our liters cancel out, and that gives us 0.00504 moles of H2SO4. We know from our balanced chemical reaction here that for every 1 mole of H2SO4, we have 2 moles of NaOH. And that comes from properly balancing the coefficients of our chemical equation. This is going to give us 0.01008 moles of NaOH. In order to get the concentration of our sodium hydroxide, we need to divide it by the volume of our sodium hydroxide solution. And in this case, we're given 48.0 milliliters, or 0.0480 liters. If we do the math for this particular calculation, we get 0.210 molar NaOH. So this is going to be the concentration of our unknown solution, in this case of the sodium hydroxide. So when we perform these acid-base titrations, you're going to have to use typically a pipette and a burette, because the volumes that we use are going to be very, very precise, which is going to allow us to calculate each of these concentrations of our unknown solutions.